Finally, I'm having a first look at the micro-OLED optical engine for Pimax Crystal Super. How well does micro-OLED panels and pancake lenses really perform, especially compared to the other QLED panel optical engines we already have for the Super? Well, let's find out. QLED or micro-OLED, which one is better and which one of these panel technologies would you prefer? I would say, why not just have both? Or even three versions using different modules working with one single headset. Now, we also have a fourth module, or as Pimax calls it, optical engine, housing Sony micro-OLED panels coupled with brand new Pimax Concave View pancake lenses. You see, that's the beauty of Pimax Crystal Super. It has a modular design allowing to swap the entire optical engine in seconds. If you want to do racing simulators with the widest field of view possible, then plug in the ultra-wide 50 ppd module. Want to perform desktop work or fly DCS world with the highest clarity and the resolution possible? Then swap to the 57 ppd QLED module. For casual VR gaming, just pick the standard 50 ppd module. It's crazy that it's even possible, don't you think? And if you are that type of guy who loves pure OLED blacks, extreme contrast levels, and exceptional clarity, whether you're playing VR games, grinding simulators, or watching movies, well, then the micro OLED optical engine is here for you. But there is more into the micro OLED module for the Crystal Super, more than just true blacks, contrast and colors. And I want to dig into it and give you some more details. Bear in mind, this is an in-house pre-production sample of the micro OLED optical engine and not a final production sample. In fact, during my week at the Pimax headquarters, I got to test two samples where both had minor changes on the housing details, yet the same functionality. At the first glance, the new optical engine module looks a bit different from the other 50 and 57 ppd modules. That is because it's using concave view pancake lenses and not aspheric lenses like the others. Since micro OLED panels are extremely small in comparison to the other Crystal Super QLED panels, aspheric lenses would just not work here. These lenses here are the same new pancake lenses that the upcoming Dream Air also is equipped with. By now, I guess you have probably seen the latest Pimax Sync presentation hosted by me and Yap, where the concave view lenses are explained in more detail. They are better, bigger, they allow for a wider field of view than any other existing pancake lens on the market, while also providing perfect clarity with barely any glare and with a proper distortion-free image. If you want to know more about the technology, go check out the latest Pimax Sync video here on YouTube. Anyway, it kind of hit me how big these concave view pancake lenses really are. Even when used with a larger headset like a Super, they don't feel undersized. And they're not much smaller than the aspheric lenses of the 50 and 57 ppd modules. But they are much lighter than the aspheric lenses, removing a lot of the weight from the headset. But more about that in a moment. IPD is adjustable, of course, and once the integrated Tobii eye tracking is enabled, then Auto IPD can also handle it for you automatically. As of now, eye tracking is already there in the module, but not enabled in the software. Once I powered on the Crystal Super with the micro OLED engine, I started to mess around in Steam VR Home and test HMD, of course. There are a few things that caught my attention immediately. The field of view, the pixel density, and in general, the image quality that's quite similar to what I've seen on the Dream Air prototype earlier this year. I know that field of view is important for you, so let's begin with that. In test HMD, I estimate my horizontal field of view reaching 116 degrees, while the vertical field of view peaked at 88 degrees. Of course, the vertical field of view could have been better, but horizontal field of view is impressive. I'm actually quite happy that the numbers correspond well with the officially stated numbers in the presentation recently. In other words, you get exactly what's advertised. Well done, Pimax. It's a horizontal field of view that is a lot bigger than we get with the 57 ppb module, as well as the Crystal Light and the original Crystal. The 50 ppb module have a wider field of view, especially the ultra-wide version, but it's not a dramatic difference, I would say. Especially in casual gameplay, Crystal Super Micro OLED module still gives a wider horizontal field of view than most other VR headsets out there. And the more field of view, the better, especially for flight and racing simulators, but also very helpful with awareness in casual VR games like first-person shooters. The binocular overlap or stereo overlap is also way better than I expected. And WinFob, or what is my field of view tool, says roughly 73% binocular overlap. But in my opinion, this is the best binocular overlap I have seen on a Pimax headset. And I can't imagine anyone actually complaining about the overlap this time. Now, here's something crazy for you. During my stay for roughly a week at the Pimax headquarters, Robin and the engineer team provided me with another two different distortion profiles for the Super Micro OLED. One of these profiles even had a slightly wider horizontal field of view than those 116 degrees, and it added also another 6 or 8 degrees more on the vertical field of view. On top of that, the binocular overlap was almost 93 degrees, which is insane. The beauty is that eventually we will have multiple profiles or modes to choose from directly inside of Pimax Play with a click of a button. What do you think about those only 88 vertical degrees of field of view I mentioned? You can be assured that we will have a bigger vertical field of view available for this Micro OLED optical engine upon shipments of the first batches, that's for sure. And I will soon follow this up, making a separate video comparing a few other profiles with this optical engine, since I luckily got to keep one sample and bring it back home. Now, let's talk about the pixel density. Still today, I haven't got an official ppb number this new Micro OLED is offering, but one thing is for sure, the pixel density looks better or higher than with the standard 50 ppb QLED does. Whatever the exact ppb is for the Micro OLED optical engine, there is another factor that makes it look better than the 50 ppb module. I suspect it has something to do with the pixels or the subpixels of the Micro OLED panels having less of a gap in between. I really like what I see here, because the high pixel fill rate or fill factor eliminates jagged edges, shimmering, and renders a noticeably less aliased image overall. That is a huge thing for simulator guys and enthusiasts and picky guys like me. Straight lines, tiny text, and the cockpit panels, for instance, just looks cleaner, more sharp, and more defined this way. Also, there is less need of using additional supersampling or anti-aliasing filters in games. Then, the optical image quality, which I instantly realized has a huge advantage over QLED modules. I see basically no chromatic aberration at all, with maybe the first 80 degrees of the field of view. It's not completely gone though. When looking at the far peripherals, maybe 90 or 100 and plus degrees out to the left and right, there is a slight tendency to chromatic aberration, but it's really not visible or noticeable unless you start to look for it. I see no signs of Mura on these Micro OLED panels, like zero Mura. And when staring at the blue sky in a SteamVR home environment or in a flight simulator, it just looks amazingly clean. Also, glare and god rays are almost non-existent here. Normally, Micro OLED headset suffers with a tons of glare and god rays caused by optical limitations with the pancake lenses, where light is bouncing between the layers of the pancake lens. Here, while looking at the glare test in test HMD application, I really need to look hard to see any signs of glare. I'm not saying it's completely glare-free, but it's hands down the least amount of glare or god rays I've ever seen in a pancake lens headset till this day. The distortion profile is excellent, by the way. I wasn't expecting that, I mean, since it's still a pre-production unit, right? I am a daily user of the 50 and the 57 ppb optical engines, which both have near-perfect distortion-free lens profiles. And here, with the Micro OLED sample, it's really not that far off. edge distortions are almost completely sorted out now. What specifically stands out is this sweet spot, which is insanely good considering we're using pancake lenses here. Not expected, honestly. Either way, it's hard to actually not hit the sweet spot when putting on the headset. It's also very obvious when making through the lens captures with my phone, where I found it's extremely easy to get the good shots, like you see here throughout this video. Then what about image clarity? Well, what can I say? It's just crystal super. The clarity is super good. At this point, I feel I'm so spoiled by using high-end headsets from Pimax on a daily basis, so the perfect clarity and the pixel-free resolution is just something I take for granted these days. And I know I shouldn't. Despite the fact that these Sony Micro OLED panels have a bit lower resolution, which is 3840 by 3552 compared to the QLED's 3840 by 3840, the difference in resolution and clarity is not noticeable or even non-existent. To describe clarity here, I would say it's somewhere in the ballpark of the 50 and the 57 PPD modules. In fact, running Pimax Play resolution at 1.0, the Micro OLED is somewhat sharper at distance compared to the 50 PPD optical engine. In the SteamVR Home Environment test chart, the smallest text on the Snellen chart is fully readable, maybe like 6 or 7 meters away, standing right in front of the beach ball or right next to it. If you haven't seen my previous 57 PPD video, the distance is not as far here, but it's very, very impressive. Running DCS World and flying FA-18 Hornet, I tried what I'd done before with the 50 and 57 PPD models. I look at the green line at the digital display indicator and I see barely any jagged edges. They're still there a little bit, but this indeed looks better than with the 50 PPD QLED. Whether it's due to the optics, the Micro OLED pixel fill factor or the resolution and pixel mapping, I simply cannot tell. There's just something about these Micro OLED panels that deliver a very sharp, detailed and clean image, almost completely free of aliasing and shimmering. And there is more into it. The rendered resolution this Micro OLED module is running with Pimax Play image quality set to 1.0 is 5352 by 4088 pixels per eye, which is considerably lower than what the 50 PPD module renders at the same settings. Same when image quality is set to medium or 0.75, that generates a rendered resolution of 4012 by 3068 pixels per eye. In comparison, the 50 PPD module needs a way higher resolution with the same image quality setting. And that's a very good sign, because both resolutions are way more playable and forgiving on the GPU. The lower rendered resolution, the more extra GPU headroom, and potentially better frame rates you will get. And this despite keeping the same visual fidelity or even a higher clarity than you will do with the 50 PPD module. It's kind of a win-win scenario here. Then of course, let's talk about Micro OLED blacks and colors. No matter how much we praise the QLED with the local dimming, there's nothing like OLED panels when it comes to presenting pure blacks and high contrast levels in dark games. Here, OLED and the Micro OLED panels will take the victory every time, hands down. Flying at night in DCS World or any other flight simulator such as Airfly FS2, it's amazing looking now. Furthermore, I do not see any black crash whatsoever, even in very high contrast scenes. So the image is never too dark where it's not supposed to be. Lastly, in terms of comfort, this module is significantly lighter than the other QLED optical engines for Crystal Super. The Concave View pancake lenses are lightweight, while also these Sony or Micro OLED panels are smaller and lighter, of course. I don't really complain about the Crystal Super's comfort using any other existing optical engines, but I think a lighter headset overall could be a game changer for a lot of people. So, to sum this up, the Crystal Super Micro OLED optical engine delivers an extremely sharp image with near perfect clarity. minimal aliasing and shimmering, minimal glare, almost no chromatic aberration at all, nor any Mura, and no optical distortions. On top of that, a horizontal field of view of at least 116 degrees horizontally, and potentially even higher coming up, plus an impressive binocular overlap. Is there anything that isn't good with this module? Well, honestly, I cannot find anything to nitpick on here. If only the vertical field of view was wider by another 10 degrees, which it will potentially thanks to additional distortion profiles as mentioned before, this could become the only module Crystal Super ever needs. And since this optical engine is coupled with a headset that already does eye tracking, DFR and quad views, built-in inside-out SLAM tracking, high-performance audio and native DisplayPort connection, what more are we possibly missing? The big question is now, would you find any reason to keep the QLED panel modules with the Crystal Super? Well, there's mainly two reasons for that. Field of view and brightness. If a wider field of view is your thing, then keep your 50 ppd or the ultra-wide 50 ppd combo. There's no doubt that the field of view of these two QLED optical engines will remain bigger. And that could be a game changer for some people. Secondly, the brightness levels, especially peak brightness levels, with micro OLED and pancake lenses are not nearly as high as with the other super modules using QLED panels and aspheric glass lenses. For some people, this could be an important factor. But other than that, I must admit that the micro OLED optical engine simply outshines the other QLED models in almost any criteria. Those Sony panels also, while being much more expensive, are probably the best choice Pimax has ever made. But maybe the second most important factor, these new Pimax concave view lenses are a game changer for micro OLED headsets. Huge lenses, a wide field of view, exceptional sweet spot and fantastic clarity. This technology also leads the way for the Dream Air to be a massive success, I believe. But more about that in another video coming up. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, guys, and stay tuned for more exciting things coming up next.